reaction?
Well, there's no surgery till this afternoon. All I've got to do is pop into the old people's home, so should be a nice, quiet morning.
Speak to you soon.
Excuse me, doctors. One of you is needed in casualty. I'll go. We've had a call from Mrs. Watts at Heath Farm. Her son Simon's very poorly with a fever. Can someone take a look at him?
I think I'm down for visits this morning.
I'll find his notes.
Well, you should probably know that Simon was born, well, with speech and learning difficulties.
Oh, right.
It was a complicated birth. He was born in Oxy. He's a nice lad, though.
Thanks for the tip-off.
Gordon, there you are.
Ah, good morning, Mr. Rose.
Good morning. That, domiciliary visitor requested of me. Are you free now?
Well, as it happens, yes.
Well, no, just get it over and done with it,
right?
The DHA are sending a plumber over later today to assess the damage.
We cannot function without hot water.
We're not going to need earplugs for this consultation.
It's open!
Gordon, come in, come in.
Morning, sir. May I introduce to you Mr. Rose, who's our consultant surgeon.
Mr. Edward, I'm pleased to meet you. Excuse me for not getting up, and I'm sorry that you had to let yourselves in, but George seems to have gone AWOL. George!
Okay, Simon. Now, this may hurt a bit. Good lad. Nearly done.
Well, the spinal fluid's clear, so it's not bacterial meningitis.
So, well, that's good then, yeah?
Well, it means this infection is viral rather than bacterial. We'll need to carry out more tests while we figure out what we're dealing with.
How are you feeling, Mary?
Okay.
Really? A little shattered.
She was up all night.
Well, look, if Simon's stable, I suggest you just go home and you get some rest.
Come on, love, I'll take you. I'll come back with his pyjamas and things.
Simon will be fine with us.
All right.
What in heaven's name was that?
I appear to have collided with a quadruped.
I beg your pardon?
I've hit a sheep. Stupid animal.
It's still breathing.
I don't think there's any damage to the car.
Look, I think we're going to have to get it to a vet.
What?
We can't just leave it here, can we?
You're not putting that in my car.
What do you think you're doing?
Perfectly simple, my good man.
Have you touched that sheep?
Certainly not.
Is it yours?
No. Looks like one of Harry Venables. I've just seen the vet turn down his, a couple of miles down on the right. There's been an outbreak of Looping Hill. You better leave it. And mind you, wash your hands.
Well, not for a while yet, I'm afraid. You've had a very nasty parasitic infection.
Nasty things, parasites. The worst I ever heard of is a candiroo. Tiny little fish in the Amazon swims up your you-know-what, and then it opens up like an umbrella. Excruciatingly painful. I mean, the only thing you can do is have it cut off.
Sir Edward, do you mind?
I would if I had a candiroo up my you-know-what.
Sir Edward settled in all right, I tell you.
He's making himself at home.
Oh, I'm used to roughing it. When you cope with South American headhunters, you can always make friends with a nun.
Turn the hot tap on, then.
Have you fixed it?
I hope so, or I'm going to be out of a job.
It appears that Jack has attempted to solve our crisis for the last 24 hours by installing a piece of scrap metal from a ship. in the basement.
So the DHA...
have done nothing.
This is really not good enough, Jack.
DHA were going to take weeks. We'd have closed down.
Well, it appears we will anyway, having wasted a full day. On the other hand, what you've done could be seen as an excellent use of your initiative. Congratulations.